Hello, Poison Crafter! So nice of you to join me. My name is WhoDys, and welcome back to Moons of Madness. And if you are wondering, hey, did he fucking lost his mind by playing that game? No, that was like a Kenny reference from South Park. You goddamn uncultured swines that are looking at my fucking channel. How won't you get my fucking Kenny reference? God damn it, man, you're so weak. So, last time, we collected the... Let me go back, actually. So, we need one more thing for the tablet here, so we can unlock the Tome of Cthulhu. And we just completed the picture puzzles. And now, I guess we either have to switch the light off, or I remember that we had a door in the basement that I didn't open for some fucking reason. And where was it? That goddamn door. Was it like around here or am I fucking delusional? Yeah, here. Okay. Ooh, hey! Oh. Am I back? How does this work? Huh. Interesting. Okay. So you know what's the last thing that I must do, right? I hope you know. I hate it. Let's switch it exponentially. Okay. Okay. Easy. Calm down, man. You don't know that's bad until you see if it's bad. Do you get me? I think he does get me. So that thing is fucking shining right now. Is anyone there? I have some light, but I can't fucking compare. Let's go easy. The fucking monkey. This is like developing photos or some shit like that. Hey! Creepy fucking bitch. Yay! Have at it. Have at it, little man. Enjoy your life. Have fun. Because I won't. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. Who the fuck is in my house? Fool? You picked the wrong house to be fucking here. Fuck off. What do you need? Do you need a spank? What is that? Is that? It's fucking... I'm gonna slap that shit out of you. What the fuck is going on? Come on, man. Come on. Have at it. No glowing symbols. No glowing symbols. I must glow them. Glow the bitch out of them. Okay. So, how do you want the spanking, man? So, they said knock on the door. I guess on the ones with post-its on it. This one has a post-it on it. How do I can't knock on this because there's no door. Like, game, have some mercy on me. You see, I'm stupid. Like, why don't you throw me a bone? Like, give me some kind of hint or something. What? Why? What happened? What happened? Why? Is that a rune? Okay, bro. Okay.
My brain was melting.
What?
Those symbols were similar to the ones at the altar.
Okay. But how is this, like, helping me? Those symbols? What symbols? I see only one. Oh, look, another. Do I need to, like, stay close to them and activate them? Do they need to be white? Do they need to be red? I don't understand. I guess I need to find them in the dark. It's like, look, another one here. Oh yeah, there was the... Oh, you can actually see them. Okay, I have four fucking things in my eyes now. I guess that's not hell. Mom, what the fuck are you doing to me? Okay. Apparently, that's how things work. Klaatu Barada Orochi. One third of what? Of my death? It's fucking here? Pick up! Jesus fucking Christ! I guess I could... I will never be able to read that fucking Tome of Cthulhu. Why am I picking it with my right hand that has that symbol that activates everything in this fucking world? And I'm picking it with my normal fucking hand that I can fap with! Sabotage signal. Well, I mean, that's no good.
Did I drift off?
Man.
Dream. It feels so real. The hair on the back of my neck is still standing on end.
So he never went down into that fucking cave. Like, what? I mean, that's at least what the game implies. Or someone just opened my fucking... Oh, there's no fucking cave here.
Declan.
So...
Declan. No response. Calm's still down.
Okay, the thing is not the same, and this was not here, that's for sure. Let's see if the things are still here. New password, 7357. Let me write that down. So... I have a lot of notes because I'm playing Payday and I write a lot of codes down, so I hope I'm not gonna... Okay, I guess this is good. Okay. Whatever, what were we doing? Okay, so we got the new code, this is still fucked. Oh, but I can interact with it, okay. So, I can connect, yeah, and it has no power. And the dish is up there, so we need to move this out of the way, and we need to find the power cell. Okay, so what's here? Nothing. Cool. Can I... This is all. I can just go up, start the car, and leave. Doesn't look like any power cell is inside, so let's look somewhere else. Oh, there's something there in the distance. Maybe there's some kind of... I don't know, some kind of shit. The landscape looks really cool. Like, look at all this shit and tell me it's not fucking cool. I guess those lights are supposed to guide me somewhere, but why am I not taking the car and I'm just walking like a fucking peasant? I mean... So they are still going in that direction, but I'm not sure if, like, I should follow them. I'm going pretty far away from there. Do you think this is a good idea? Return to the campsite scan to find... Okay, I'm going back. Stop. Easy. I know that's the out of bounds thing, and you have to return or else nothing good is happening. But like, how do they explain that to the story? What the fuck was that thing? Power up the digger. Who's the digger? Oh my god, I didn't see this. Oh, I was running amok like a fucking idiot when I had this. Oh my fucking god, I hate when they do this. Why couldn't they place that shit here?
Oh Jesus. No, this is crazy. Who would even...
Nah, this is art. This is art, man. You don't know about art. You're too fucking... Okay, I'm just looking at the oxygen level now, and this is not fine. I need to refill to make another fill of my oxygen. Yeah, so like I said, that's just art. So listen, listen, listen is like a message, a repetition that the artist used so they can add more meaning and more depth to their piece of shit. I don't know, man. And here we go, fucking finally. Okay, let's connect to this bad boy. Start engine. Test then. Oh, nice, nice, nice. Perfect. I want to close it, but at the same time I don't, so I won't. What's here? Can I go up and reach the other side like this? Maybe, I don't know. Move it some other way. I can't view the log. And I don't have the hydraulic, so it's gonna remain in place. And I can't go there. I will fall. Okay, let's climb then. I don't know, maybe there's some secret there, but
I hope to God he's in the habitat.
Climb. In the habitat. What's a habitat? Oh, another elevator. This requires power from the knowledge I have, right? I could have gone through there or something.
The elevator seems to be malfunctioning.
God fucking damn it. Or can I go through here? I think I can go through here.
If it was a dream, then why is my scar still warm?
What scar? Oh, the one on your hand? Who knows, man? You're fucking weird. Why would you have a scar in the first place?
Okay,
what are
one
you?
Stack of rocks. Fine. This, though, Declan is either really bored or somebody... I don't know. Let's just hope he has too much time on his hands.
I mean, it's clearly not Declan because he looks like a normal human being. But why the rocks? Like, how is that helping? Just that, like a warning, like message, like, bitch, stay the fuck away from my turf. This is my fucking turf, you piece of shit. Like, I can understand, but at the same time, like, bruh, meh. Can I align those solar panes again? Because it bothers me that they are not aligned like they should be. Ah, my fucking god. Boop. Yep. Uh-huh. Cool. Mm-hmm. Can I do something? I'm looking all over the place for things that I can do. Maybe, I don't know. With this game, you can never know for sure, man. Okay, we finally reached the top. What are we doing here? I'm just checking the camera to see if I have enough time. And battery, because that's one of my main problems. The battery drains really fast. I don't know if I'm doing something or it's just the way it is. But I'm tempted to buy another just to have consecutive things registered. Anywho, here we are. Yay! And we're gonna enter this second base. This is fucking weird. Is that the backpack? Who cares? Oh, whoa, wait. I almost took off my mask, but I remembered that I almost died like a fucking 3 times. And now I learned. See? The more you know. I guess both masks have the same amount of oxygen as the one I use, so I don't think there's a reason. I'm always careful because you...
Declan, you hear? Declan! It's empty? Declan!
That's fucking
damn
red.
Where are you?
And do you notice that this is not normal?
Don't freak out. Just find out where he is.
Like, they're fucking dirty. They, on these operations on space, they could hire a maid or a cleaning person or something like that, so they won't be like dirty peasants. Huh. I won't disturb that shit. That's crime scene.
This
a policeman should go there.
Chelsea was right.
Yeah.
Jesus, I didn't know it was like this.
Yeah.
How does he live like this?
So this is Declan. Yeah, let's look at Declan. Declan de la Porte, engineer. Okay. Okay, this looks like new to do, I guess, temporary route, circuit boxes, run a biogauge scan, manually calibrate satellite dish. Where is Shane? Okay, all personnel, Sandstorm, chief engineer, okay. Code name, okay. Shane, where are you? If you see this, we're headed back to base. We waited, but you were nowhere. I'm with Josie and Lucas, and we're taking the rover back. We lose contact for a second, your rover coordinates disappear, and suddenly the satellite goes nuts. I don't know if it was the freak sandstorm or what, doesn't matter. Get back to base, contact us, whatever you can do. I just hope you see this, Declan. I don't remember if I'm Shane, but that looks like bad news. So they all left. Like, this is clearly not just messiness. Oh, Jesus.
Shit, this is bad.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Declan. I didn't know Declan. How bad it was.
I call him Declan
can't
because...
can't stay alone out here anymore.
Because...
he needs help.
Because... I call him Declan because I can. Fuck off. Okay. Declan, write off your fantastic adventures that... Oh, that's cute. I like it. That gave this to me. We had this little 12-10-10 case of personal effects that we could seal up before lunch, and I almost left this behind, but it helps to write sometimes. Not sure why lying bothers me so much. My dad, my sister, they still think I'm freezing my ass off for climate studies in Antarctica. This is the same lie that Shane, I said to my family, so I guess this is like a secret mission or something like that on Mars. I don't know about fantastic adventures, father dearest, but last night I dream I was on one of those celebrity dance shows and my partner was Katherine Hepburn and we won even though she was obviously dead. But it was great. Then I woke up, wrote down number from space for 6 hours and drilled a tiny hole into 17 rocks. All while being a single reinforced pane of glass away from death. It's a real roller coaster here on Mars. And this is the only entry that... Oh no? Okay, this is not the only entry. There are many fucking entries. Okay, let's get to them systematically. Let's make a voice for Declan. So, must be the Gallic side of me coming out. I've been building cairns. I used to do a lot of hiking. I get annoyed by the little rock piles people would build along the trails. As if to say, I was here. I have developed fine motor skills. Look at me. But the bonus of hiking on Mars is the leave no trace ethos. It's kind of optional on a completely deserted wasteland. During EVAs, I started to just take a moment, grab a few loose pieces and build a cairn. My little zen garden balancing the rocks, it felt nice. So, he did actually build all those things. Lately though, I see the rocks moving. I tested my theory. Although in the fuck all most limited and scientific way, I'd make a new stack with the finest Martian rock samples I could find, pristine, dusty rocks. And then I'd wait a day. They wouldn't fall over. No, that'd be too simple. One stack would have a single rock swapped. Not an easy rock like the top piece, but a centerpiece. One centerpiece swapped from this stack to the other. No glove marks, nothing. Just two shitty Martian rocks that I swear change places in the middle of the night. Why am I writing this? When a person is drowning, their throat seizes up, preventing water from entering their lungs, but also air. The reflex is so strong, you could be floating there with your mouth well above the water surface, unable to cough, unable to breathe. You don't drown because you're underwater, you drown because of yourself. Sticking a needle in the webbing between your toes, it sounds so horrific, like your natural reflexes would kick in, but it's the reverse. The emotions dive, the depression slams you with a singular focus. Your mind starts justifying it all, releasing a hint of those chemicals. You're pretty much a tiny little voice trying to control this monstrosity. It's nearly impossible. And so this natural reflex to hurt yourself so terribly and specifically becomes everything. So you drown in it. Jesus Christ, my hand is shaking. I think I'll sleep at base tonight. Gotta get out of here for a bit. I guess the things that were affecting all of us are affecting Declan more because he's in this region. But that last thing was so fucking fucked. I haven't been sleeping well. Understatement. Sometimes I can't tell when I'm awake or dreaming. The numbers keep coming, the messages starts to make sense. Spending time at the base doesn't help. It's a hassle trying to come up with reasons why I need a rover ride every day. Just a bit of casual hallucinations, everyone, nothing to worry about. If you could pick me up before the flashback starts at around 6 in the evening, that'd be swell. Maybe I'll build another car and let the witch move the rocks around. Fun pastime. Wish I had a beach chair and a margarita. Might as well enjoy my descent into insanity. So this is what he saw, and it's the same exact same thing that we saw on the base. And he said, like, the witch, and he was like, I'm joking, man, but he wasn't. He wasn't fucking joking. I saw the witch today. I'm still shaking. Looked out the window and my sister is standing on the cliffside. My sister! She was stark naked in the nothing of Mars, choking, eyes bulging out of her head like a goldfish fallen out of a bowl. Nearly killed myself throwing my suit on. I get out there. I run, stumbling around the barriers. Instead, there is a person with a paleness to her, deep black hair, and she is facing away, looking out over the endless dunes. When she turns to look at me, it's not my sister. A deep black hole where a face might be, a gray slit curl into a smile. I feel and taste granules of sand pouring into my open mouth, and suddenly I can't breathe. She slowly draws nearer as I slam my fist on my chest, trying to breathe. Tendrils of blackness reach out from that endless void in her skull. I'm sinking into the desert. She's trying to pull me under, and I wake up gasping for air. I don't lose it like this, I just don't. Fuck this. I mean, Declan, god damn it, man, like, why, like, didn't you tell us or some shit? I don't know, man, like, this is not the kind of shit that you keep for yourself. So she was there, like, where are those barriers, I guess. And I saw the exact same thing when I was at the other base, if you remember. I have a creeping feeling that I need to take this, but at the same time, I will leave it here. The thing I get from this is the fact that I need to go back to base because of that mail. I mean, I think that's the oldest one. Fuck off. But I'm not so sure, so I'm gonna want to see. He couldn't be up there, could he? Or he is. Is he up here? I guess he is. And I needed the fucking power cell, as I said, the BRB. And I take this, thank you very much. I am not looking anywhere else, don't mind me. I am just living out of here. Boing. And I am opening this fucking beach. Woo! Cool. I'm just gonna go up, see what's up there, and finish, because I mean those fucking notes, if you really think about them, they're fucking so fucking not sad, like, I don't know, disturbing. Okay, button. Thank you, button. Arigato.
Doing good, chief. Don't look down.
Like, why would that matter? I want to look down if I see some shit, some fucking witch standing in there.
What is that?
What?
Holy shit!
What?
No. Oh my god, please just be a meteor. Oh my god.
Was that like a fucking ship blowing the shit out? Am I the only one on Mars, man? Because that's not cool. I'm just gonna quickly enter around here. Okay, cool. Now I need a checkpoint because I don't want to backtrack the next time and I can't get the checkpoint. Where's my fucking checkpoint? Okay, this is nothing, just around the... Okay, so let's just stop it here. Okay, the story is getting interesting. So Declan was fucking fighting with this for a long time and it looks like everyone knew something besides me. Like, Ina knew about the plans, Declan knew about this fucking witch, I don't know, the others knew about my fucking gigantic carrot dick and some, I don't fucking know. But I feel left out right now. I feel kind of left out. The thing that we saw, like, I don't think it's a meteor. It's clearly a ship exploding to heck, but I don't know how what to make of that, because were they at base and they were coming back here or something? I don't know. I'm fairly close. It said that a third of the moon or something like that, so I guess we're at around 35-40% of the game. So there's more to discover, and I don't want to bore you with questions right now that are gonna be answered in the next few episodes. So, yeah. But the story is getting interesting. It's not like the usual jump scare horror. It's more like the build up tension horror. Like, you go on and you expect, like, oh my god, I'm gonna get fucked. And then something appears and you're like, yeah, I die. Yeah. But we'll see in the next episodes what's up with those bitches. Anyway, cheers to you, and we'll see each other in the next episodes, where we're gonna investigate all this new base and maybe return to the old one. Bye!